Microwave test bench. There are very different components associated with this test bench. Using these components, we can configure 6 different type of configuration and we can perform various number of experiments with this test bench. In this test bench, the first component is the Cleaston power supply. This is the main switch to turn it on. This is voltage selector switch. This is beam voltage and this is repeller voltage, and this is meter selector switch. So I have select beam voltage. The range of beam voltage is from 198 to around 450. This is current. With the help of the beam voltage, we can increase current. And this is repeller voltage. Its range is -7 to -269. As you can see, this is a negative voltage. This is high tension button, output on off switch. This is external modulation channel. This is for microphone. This one is modulation selection switch. The first one is continuous wave CW mode. Here no modulation signal will be applied. This is amplitude modulation. Here square wave modulating signal is applied to the beam voltage. This is frequency modulation. Here sweep modulation is applied to the beam voltage. This is external modulation. Here external modulation signal is accepted for modulation, and this is for microphone. This is AM modulation. There are two potentiometer. This is frequency potentiometer. It controls the frequency or square wave signal, and this is amplitude potentiometer. It controls amplitude and square wave signal. This is frequency modulation. There is also two potentiometer. This is frequency potentiometer, controls the frequency or sweep modulating signal, and this is amplitude. It controls amplitude or sweep signal. This is the output. You can see here, this is 8 pin output terminal. This is the cooling fan to cool the Cleaston tube. Whenever we will do any experiments, remember to turn on the cooling fan, as if we don't turn on the cooling fan, there is a chance that the Cleaston tube will be damaged. So this is the Cleaston tube. This is the isolator. Isolator will always be in the direction of load. This is variable attenuator, like this. This is frequency meter. This is slotted line. By using this knob, we can move it like this. This is the pin modulator. Like this. This is the SS tuner, and this is matched termination, and this is VSWR meter. This is VSWR meter. This is range selector switch. There is, you can see there is range from 0 to 60 dB. This is crystal. This is input impedance selector switch. There is two range, one is 200 ohm low input impedance and this is 200k high input impedance. This is the mode select switch. We can select normal mode like this or audio mode. This is display mode selection switch. We can either select this in SWR mode or in DB mode. This is gain knobs, this is coarse gain and this is fine gain. This is audio output terminal and this is input terminal. This is the user manual for the microwave test bench. This comes with the kit. Here you can see that a detailed description is given for all the equipments. This is gun power supply, this is piston power supply for VSWR meter. Each experiments is given here with step by step procedures, and the theory for each experiments is also given here, so that student, anyone who is performing the test can have better understanding. And also there is a chart given here for the microwave components to easily identify the components and set up the configuration. Also, our first experiment is to study the characteristics of reflex klystron tube and to determine its electronic tuning range. For this we will need a VSWR meter, but we also can use DSO like I am using here. So first, turn on the klystron power supply and keep the current at around 25 milliampere. Please note that the current should not exceed above 25 milliampere. Now set this amplitude knob in mid position and the repeller voltage at fully clockwise position, and select amplitude mode in modulations with the help of modulation selection switch. Now keep this variable attenuator at maximum position, that means no attenuation position, like this. Now tune the reflector voltage knob to get maximum reading. You can see this here in CRO. This is the maximum reading. Now turn this plunger to get maximum reading on the CRO. Also tune this to get the maximum reading. This is the maximum reading. Now slowly rotate this frequency meter till we get the minimum frequency. This is the minimum frequency. Read the frequency from here, frequency meter. The frequency should be this one. around 10.03. Our next experiment is to determine the frequency and wavelength in a rectangular waveguide. So for this, first make sure that this knob is fully clockwise position, and this and the modulation selection switch is in amplitude modulation. This AM modulation, in AM modulation, amplitude will be in fully clockwise, and this frequency knob will be in mid position. Select the range switch in 50 dB and the crystal will be in 200 ohm and the mode will be in normal mode. The display will be in dB mode and the gain knob will be in mid position. Now I am giving power supply to the distant power supply. Current will be from 15 to 20 milliampere, and this is my beam voltage. Now adjust this both potentiometer knob frequency and amplitude to get the maximum reading in VSWR meter. So this is my maximum position. This is my maximum reading in VSWR meter. Now tune this plunger of quiescent tube to get the maximum reading in VSWR meter. So this is the maximum reading. So keep the plunger position there. Now tune the reflector voltage knob to get maximum reading. So this is the maximum reading. Now tune this probe. This is the maximum reading. So keep the probe in this position. Now turn this frequency meter. Tune this frequency meter to get a deep So this is the maximum reading. So take the reading frequency, reading of frequency from here directly. It is around 8.66 the frequency. Take this reading. And now detune the frequency meter. Now we need to move this tunable probe along the slotted line to get maximum reading, to get minimum reading in the VSWR meter. So I am moving this probe along the slotted line. So this is my minimum position. So take the reading from here and let it be D1, and again move the slotted line to get next minimum position. So this is my next minimum position. Take the reading. Take this reading from the probe here and let it be D2. Now with the help of this formula, lambda g equals to 2 into D1 minus D2, we can calculate the guide wavelength, and from this formula we can calculate the frequency following this equation. Our next experiment is to measure the impedance. So give beam voltage at around 300. Also make sure that the current does not exceed above 25 milliampere, otherwise there is a chance that the equipments will be damaged. So keep the current in 24 to 25 and the beam voltage will be around 300. Now set this repeller voltage knob fully clockwise position. Select the AM modulation, and the frequency potentiometer knob will be in mid position and the amplitude modulation knob will be in fully clockwise position. Now make sure that the cooling fan is on. Now this in VSWR meter, make sure the mode select, the mode is in normal mode. The crystal here will be at 200 ohm and the gain control knob, coarse gain and fine gain will be in mid position. Now we need to tune the reflector voltage this to get the maximum reading in frequency meter. So select this and tune the voltage to get the maximum reading in VSWR meter. So this is my maximum reading we are getting. Now we need to tune the amplitude and frequency control knob from power supply to get the maximum reading in VSWR meter. So this is my maximum reading. I am tuning the frequency meter, frequency knob. So in frequency knob, this is my maximum reading in VSWR meter. Now tune this tunable probe. This is the maximum reading. Now tune the frequency meter. Tune the frequency meter and take the reading of frequency meter from here. So here this is my frequency, this one. Note down the frequency from here. It will be 8.41 something, and after that keep this depth of SS tuner, it's 3 to 4 millimeter, and lock this.